Welcome friends, welcome back to the kitchen. Today we're going to do an ice cream flavor that I really enjoyed last year when we were in Mexico City. Jules and I were tramping around Mexico City learning about tacos al pastor. We ate a lot of paletas. And one of the ice cream flavors that I really liked was a mocha flavor with cajeta put into it. So I'm going to make sort of a mocha ice cream today. I'm going to use our basic ice cream base that I use for all of our ice creams. And that is heavy cream, whole milk, skim milk powder, and this is just a protein, and the protein helps to make a smoother ice cream at the end. Yes, the dreaded corn syrup. I put in about a tablespoon of corn syrup because the invert sugar in corn syrup changes the way that water crystals freeze. You get smaller water crystals. Smaller water crystals mean smoother ice cream. You have to do all these little tips and tricks to get it right at home because you're not able to freeze it quickly enough or to a cold enough temperature using any home ice cream machine. I don't care what it is. Next in is some milk chocolate. And I asked about this because I thought they'd be using a darker chocolate, but no, they were using a milk chocolate. So I'm going to stir this all together and bring it up to about 160 to 170 degrees Fahrenheit. I want to bring it up to that temperature so that the milk is scalding hot to temper the eggs, but also to melt the chocolate into the mixture. While we're waiting for that, I'm going to mix the sugar into these egg yolks. And later in the recipe, we're going to put in this cajeta, which I made myself. You can check out that recipe video. And this coffee liqueur, which I also made myself, and you can check out that recipe video. I'll put links to those in the description box below with the recipe. The milk mixture has come up to temperature, so it's time to temper the eggs. And it's really easy. Don't let anyone tell you that it's hard. You just drizzle in a little bit of milk at a time, whisking furiously. Bring the egg yolks up to temperature without scrambling them. Not hard. Hardest thing is not spilling down the side of the pan. Now, we pour this mixture back into the pot and we bring this up to 170 degrees Fahrenheit. That's going to do two things. It's going to give us the custard texture that we're looking for and it's going to pasteurize or cook the eggs so there's no raw egg in your ice cream. Gently bring it up to temperature. Don't let it boil. We are at 170 degrees, so back into the mixing jug. And I'm gonna let this cool to room temperature before I add the coffee liqueur. So it's over 95 degrees in the studio here today. This has cooled down as far as it's going to cool down. I'm going to add the coffee liqueur. I just didn't wanna add it when it was super hot right off of the stovetop. High heat can drive off some of the volatile flavor compounds and I don't want to lose them. So I'm not a huge coffee fan. I like coffee in things. I like mocha. So I'm going to go a little bit easy. I'm going to put in 2 tablespoons of our homemade coffee liqueur. You can use Kahlua if you want to. If that's what you have, go ahead and use it. Any coffee liqueur will be fine. So I'm just going to stir this in and then I'm going to move it to the fridge and let it cool down completely. And I'm probably going to leave it in the fridge overnight before I put it into the ice cream machine. Now, for those of you who are worried about putting 2 tablespoons of coffee liqueur and alcohol into your ice cream mix, there is less alcohol in this, or Kahlua for that matter, than there would be in the same amount of vanilla extract. And you've never thought about vanilla extract at all when it comes to alcohol content, I can assure you. So this is exactly the same thing. It's not gonna get you drunk. It's not even gonna get you close to drunk. Alcohol is just a carrier for flavors, an incredibly good carrier for flavors. So I'll see you back here tomorrow. And once everything is cool, just pour the mix into the ice cream machine. And it may be a little clumpy after it's sat in the fridge overnight, but just give it a really good stir, it'll be okay. And there you go. When it was about halfway frozen, I added in the mix-ins, which was some clumps of cajeta, some almonds, and some chocolate chips, just for good measure. Just let it continue.
All right, more ice cream. Okay, so we're having a little ice cream fest, apparently.
This, I don't know. Let's give it a go.
Hi, friends. I'm so excited about ice cream.
So I was trying to recreate one of the paletas that we had in Mexico City.
Yeah, it's got that chocolate coffee. I'm not a big fan of coffee flavored things at all.
It's mocha.
Oh, sorry. Mocha.
Mocha.
Doesn't matter. But the chocolate and the other flavors are very good.
Yeah. And it's super smooth.
It is super smooth.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
And it's just so hot that
mm-hmm.
I'm happy to have something cold and refreshing.
Now you could drizzle some of that on top for a little added extra. I don't think it needs it. I don't think it needs it.
You could potentially leave out the coffee.
You could leave out the coffee. So I didn't put in coffee. I put in coffee liqueur.
Okay. The coffee
still,
flavor?
Yeah. You could leave out the coffee flavor completely. And if you still wanted the added smoothness from the alcohol, you could use a chocolate liqueur.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Or leave out both of the liqueurs and just put in vanilla. Vanilla would do the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
It'd be really good. So this is another fantastic ice cream. I really like this one. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.